गाइस वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 10 दैट इज इंक्रीमेंटल मॉडल। सो इट इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट असेंशियल मॉडल्स अमंग द सिक्स टॉप मॉडल्स ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर टेस्टिंग। सो एज यू कैन सी लाइक इन इंक्रीमेंटल मॉडल देर आर स्पेसिफिक बिल्ड्स। लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई विल बी प्रोवाइडिंग विद वन ऑफ द लाइव एग्जाम्पल्स इटसेल्फ। लाइक you do have one of the paintings with you, okay, and that paintings does have a horse in it. So suppose build one includes like you need to complete only up till the head of the horse, okay. So this is build one. Like that means you need to start painting and end the painting up till the particular face of horse has been made, okay, or has been painted. The next build includes from the neck of the horse to the tail of the horse is the second build. That means from neck to tail, the second part of the painting has to be built and joined. And lastly, the entire tail and legs are being covered into the build three. Okay, so after that, once these builds are being completed, then what you are doing is like you are just collaborating those builds, and this way what you are doing is like you are making your task very easy actually. So build generally here means the code, okay. Build here means the part of the application, okay. So build one, build two, and build n. Build n means you can take any number of build in order to complete the application, testing and designing. Okay, so this is what incremental model is all about. So build one includes design and development. That means you are taking the requirement document and simply creating a design of what exactly you will be doing for build one for that particular application. Suppose that application includes sign-in page. So the first build includes sign-in page, second phase includes when you are entering into that application, and third build includes you are going into your friend list and just viewing your friends over there. Okay, so these are into three builds. So first build includes the sign-in phase. That means you are designing that particular sign-in page. Then you are developing those sign-in page. After that is move on to the testing team, where they'll be testing the phase one designing and development part, detecting the errors if any, and last but not the least, implementation. And implementation means like, okay, now this particular build is ready and is ready for the execution. And further, if it requires any change, like it will be asked to the development team for further improvement into this particular build. So this way, what we can do is like the very first advantage over here is customers can take the products build by build. That means early release can happen for a particular build. Secondly, it is very flexible model. And third, it is very easy to test because there is no burden upon the testing team as well as the development team over here. But there are certain disadvantages also, because as you can see, like you are building these into different builds. That means cost will be high. Secondly, clarity on end goals is not that much effective. Sometimes what happen is like when you try to combine these modules or builds into one single thing, then sometimes it can create an issue. Last but not the least, it really requires a good planning and also phase by phase implementations and planning of those phases. How much time will be required for a particular phase or a particular plan to get implemented. So here development team, testing team will get equal opportunities, plus they need to collaborate with one another in order to completely work out with incremental model stuff. Okay guys, so this was all about incremental model. Now question over here is like which are basically asked in interviews is they will ask you the practical scenario. Suppose, for example, you do have one of the application and your team wants the customer to get the things done as early as possible. Now, which model you'll be using? So you can say, like, you can use incremental model because you will be providing build by build functionality to the customers, and this way the customer is also satisfied. Okay, and he is also seeing, like, okay, this particular team or this particular organization is helping the helping us to work efficiently and requires very much time, and they are giving us some sort of work. They are showing and highlighting us the work. And they will be happy for this particular performance from any sort of organization which is working on incremental model. So hope this will help, and read more about incremental model from other sources as well. Try to imagine lots and lots of stuffs by giving yourself various examples. Try to take different applications and examples, and also search through the internet what exact explanation we can give when we are asked with two to three similar examples or similar model examples. So this from my end is sufficient as of now for interview perspective, but if you still want to increase your knowledge bandwidth, then obviously you can refer the other sources as well, other internet sources as well. So just go and try not to waste any of your time just simply writing down and copying down each and everything. Try to elaborate and make a short note of everything so that it will be easy for you to prepare for the interviews. Okay, guys, so stay safe. Have a nice day.